Well, you all know by now, one of my favorite things about the Good to Be Home TV show is introducing you to some of my friends. You've met some new ones, but now you're going to meet an old friend, a dear friend. Welcome to the program, Wes Hampton. Hey, Wes.
Hey, Ernie. How are you, buddy?
Hey, doing good, man. You look great.
Thank you. You too. It is so good to see you.
Good to see you. You look like you've been out in the yard working. You got a tan or something.
Well, you know, the joke is someone's got to do the yard work around here. I have two of my boys are highly allergic, mm-hmm. and they're doing allergy shots. So guess who gets to do the yard work? Me.
if it was my dad, he would have said, get out there and roll around in that grass and get cured. That's what he would say.
Get cured.
Get cured.
Son, you'll live.
You'll live.
It. Just get out there and do it.
So you got four boys, right?
Yes, we still have four.
Oh, my man.
Four no more is still the motto around our house.
So Barrett, tell me the ages.
Okay, so Barrett, whom you met him when he was, I think, two.
This little kid.
And he is now 17, starting
his
senior year next week. It's absolutely insane. And then Hudson is 15, and then Carden is 12, and Sutton is 11.
Wow.
So we have four boys that eat all the time, Ernie. It is unreal. It is unreal. Our grocery bill is just to the roof. But it's worth it. It's worth it most days.
Oh, yes. And you got a built-in quartet right there, don't you?
Yes, people see us out in the street. Hey, you got a football team you're going for? I said, nope, I got a quartet. They just kind of look at me like, what? So,
well, you know what? I remember the first time that I met you professionally. I guess it was the first time we met that I can remember. But you said we met, you know, years before that?
Yes. Okay, so our first professional meeting, which I guess you would talk about in just a minute. But the first time I ever met you was in Memphis. I grew up outside of Memphis, mm-hmm. and I was a big, big Cathedrals fan, big vocal band fan. So the Cathedrals were in Memphis, so my parents took me, and we got there really early, and I think y'all had just finished sound check, and I ran to the bathroom, and lo and behold, you were in there, and we were both washing our hands and said, hey, Ernie, I'm Wes, introduced myself. And I remember you were, I hope you don't edit this out because I want people to know, you were so kind and so gracious to hear me, just to hear me out, you know? And I remember thinking, okay, this guy seems to be a genuine, really sweet guy. And it was so refreshing because, you know, you have your hopes of what you think the people that you really admire will be if you ever meet them. And I've heard the saying, don't ever meet your idols because you'll be disappointed. And I think that is such a sad saying because at least in my case, it has not been true in any form, in any sense of it, especially, and started with you. But it's gone on, you know, through many, many people that I've admired through the years. So, Ernie, you were so kind and so encouraging. And you just treated me like I was your friend. I think I was, I don't know, 16.
I'm so relieved to hear that. whenever anybody comes up and says, hey, the first time I met you, and I'm just inside, I'm cringing. Was that nice?
No.
Was it that bad day?
Was it a rough day for me? Exactly. Because we all have them.
We all have them. We do. We all do. Well, I professionally, and I appreciate you saying that's wonderful. I remember singing there in Memphis at, I think it was Germantown Baptist Church. So we had a great night that night. But I remember one day, we were Signature Sound, Cathedrals had already retired. Signature Sound was kind of taking off. We were touring with Bill. And he called and said, you know, we're going to have to be, I think David's going on a solo ministry again, and we're looking for some tenor singers. Do you know anybody? And I said, I don't. He goes, well, we have somebody we're trying out in a couple of days here in Alexandria at the studio. Am I remembering this correct? Did we come to your tryout?
Yeah, you came to one of many tryouts. Ernie, I counted all the days and the weeks. I think I auditioned for 7 weeks.
Ugh.
And I think that was probably, okay, I tell you exactly when that was. Okay, I was leading worship at a church in Birmingham, and we had this big student production. Long story short, I was in charge of the student production, but my bosses let me go because Bill called and said, "Hey, if you can make it away this weekend, I will make it worth your while." And I thought, what in the world does that mean? So I got their blessings. Even if I had not gotten their blessings, I still would have gone.
You get their forgiveness
But
later.
so, yeah, exactly. Always ask forgiveness. So when I first met you professionally, that was probably week 6 of my audition, okay?
Okay.
So you're pretty heavy into the audition process. So the Church of God convention was in Anderson that weekend. So he wanted me, I remember now, he wanted me to come to the studio to do some singing in the studio. I didn't know he was asking you and all the guys from Six Sound to be there. And so I met you all. You were so incredibly kind to me, so encouraging, just put me at ease because I was very nervous, anxious, excited, all those things. It's Bill
Yeah.
Gaither for crying out loud. It's the Gaither Vocal Band. You got Ernie Haase, who I grew up listening to, and it was just a lot. So I appreciate how you all put me at ease, and I think we struck up a beautiful friendship that has lasted. Here we are now, almost 16 and a half
I
years
know.
later. Can you
I
believe
remember
that?
when Bill told me, that you were in the running, and he asked. I don't know if I had any sway at all, but I mean, ladies and gentlemen, Wes Hampton, and he knows this. Wes Hampton is my favorite singer. I love his voice. It's like
Oh man,
butter,
I didn't know that.
and just it just so happens he's a great guy too. So, but man, we got the chance to go around the world together, and then
It
record that
was
huge
so
video,
fun.
that together video in
Yeah.
Louisville, and it was a great
That
run.
was really special. It
Yeah.
was. It was very, very special. And I miss that. I love the group of guys I'm with now so much. I mean, there's just not a better group of guys. But I also miss touring with you. I really do. I miss touring with you and the guys. That was so much fun. And I've got to give you credit, Ernie. When Bill offered me the job, I thought I was going to have to move to Nashville. And he called back after he asked if I would move to Nashville. I said, yeah. And I did not want to move to Nashville.
I remember that.
And so he called me back a few hours later, said, hey, I talked to Ernie. And he said his guys just commute every weekend. So if you don't have a problem commuting, then I don't see any reason for you to move to Nashville if you don't want to. And I thought, thank God. And he said it was because of Ernie. I thought, thank you, Ernie, that I did not have to move. I mean, you were the big reason why I didn't have to move. Seriously. So great.
Well,
So great.
I remember him calling me because I just afraid that everybody coming from different places, they would be late. I said, just tell him if the bus is leaving at 9, tell him it's leaving at 8.
And of course, he didn't know me. If you tell him to be there at 8 or the bus leaves at 8, I'll shoot for 7.
Yes.
I don't, that's one of my big pet peeves is
Oh,
being
me
late. I hate
too.
being late.
Me
So I'm
too.
always early. If you're on
Yes.
time, you're late. So.
That's exactly right. That's how I was raised too. Hey, you know what? You were
Yeah, you better be
talking
early.
about the way that we met and how we've enjoyed. But I've enjoyed the times that you would come to the bus with some homemade cooking or cookies or things.
Oh.
And so that's a passion of yours, isn't it?
It is. I love it. I remember making those chocolate chip bundt cakes for all the buses for the homecoming tour. Weren't those good?
Oh man, they
It's
were.
really, they're so good. And I don't really have any hobbies other than cooking. Cooking is what I do to relax. It's what I do for fun. It's what I love to do. It's a great way for me to express creativity as well. And I just love it. I don't hunt, I don't fish, I don't golf. I'm just not really
Yeah.
interested in that. I'll take my boys fishing. I'll go to Top Golf and hit some golf balls with my boys. But get me in the kitchen. That's where I'm happy.
Yeah.
So,
Well, your kitchen looks
long story
beautiful.
short.
I see you
But
sitting there
thank you.
right
This
now.
is, yes, this is our this is our this is called our quarantine kitchen
Yes.
because we built it right before the big pandemic hit. And the joke at our house is, well, we have this great finished basement that I wish we didn't have anymore. I wish we had that money instead of the basement. But yeah, it's my little downstairs kitchen that I don't really, use much at all. I have an oven. I don't think I've ever cooked on this range, but it's there
It's there,
just in
just
case,
in
you
case.
know, just in case.
Well, just in case people wanted to know more about your recipes, would you happen to have any cookbooks?
Well, Ernie, it's funny you should ask. I just happen to have two right here on this table. I don't know. It's crazy how they ended up here. But this is the first one that I wrote many years ago. And I've got to give my father-in-law Mark credit because he's the one that told me, "Hey, you've got all these recipes. Why don't you put those together in a cookbook and you'll have a piece of product for the weekend?" So that's exactly what I did. And I'm so glad that I did because during COVID, if there was one thing I could say about COVID, I was a little bit productive. I wrote the second edition, Recipes 2.0. It's now available at
Recipes.
westhampton.com. Yeah, it's
Recipes.
Recipes.
Yes.
So, yeah, you get
I got it. I got it.
it?
Oh
So,
man. Well, I'll put a link in the description below
thank
and
you.
that people can go to your website and check out your music. You're out not only with the vocal band, but you're singing and doing solo dates and you got your music and your
Yes.
cookbooks and just being very productive. And I think it's great. Before I move on, I want to say I think it's great to have a hobby. Every man, every person should have a hobby. I read
Yes.
Colin Powell's book on leadership, and his first chapter was about not being a busybody, that you got to have something that you can go. My dad loves to go tinker on cars, or I personally, I love to just shoot basketball in the driveway. That's just what I grew up doing. I still love to do that. And so
Oh, yeah.
I'm glad to hear that. And you know what? God has blessed us, and I'm so glad when you were talking
Yes.
about the little things of just saying, being nice to people. I mean, that's following the recipe for life. I mean, God put that in his wonderful word that whatever you do, do all to the glory of God. And so there's, you
Yes.
know, everything matters down to
It does.
the way you treat people just when you pass each other in 10 seconds. I don't know if this is a perfect analogy, maybe apples to oranges here, but I was just thinking as you were talking, you have a recipe for, let's say, lasagna. And a person can say, you know, I don't like what Wes has in that recipe when it comes to oregano or onion or a different kind of cheese. And you can leave that out and you're not going to die.
No.
But if you want to follow a recipe to get a five-star Michelin vote, you know, there's some other things you got to do to become a master chef. But I was
Yes.
just
Yes.
thinking, God's word is that way. He has a recipe for life. And the
Yeah.
thing is, we can leave some things out and it will hurt us. He's the
It
master
will.
chef. He knows how to create a wonderful life. And so those are not just rules. They're things to follow and to let them flourish in our
They are.
life.
I agree. And it's, I think so many of the answers I think that the world is looking for are in this book.
Yes.
They're right there in front of us. God has given us the truth of His word to guide our walk
Amen.
daily. So if you're feeling lost, no direction, whatever it is, frustrated, open up the word and pray that God would show you something, that the Holy Spirit would speak to your heart and minister to you. And that's, I believe in the power of the word. And going back to what you said, it is so important. It is so important to follow obedience and what we think maybe are the small things. To me, they're not small. Being kind to someone is not a small thing. Being kind to someone is what is asked of me as a follower of Christ. Can't talk. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you.
Yeah.
It's a simple truth, but it's a truth and it works. And just like you said, it really is like this recipe, this
Master
guide for our life
is.
of how to live our lives. And you could choose to follow it or you could choose not to follow it. But if you choose not to follow it, it's probably not going to end up like the way you wanted it to end up.
No, my favorite saying, and I don't know where I first heard this, so forgive me. I'm quoting somebody here. You have the freedom to choose what you want to leave out when you read the Bible. You have the freedom to choose, but you don't
Yeah.
have the freedom for the results. of your choice.
Yeah.
That's where truth will cut you. And if the Word of God, if you're looking for it as a piece of comfort, it's there. It's comfort food. But it can also condemn and cut and offend. And those are the things that we need, because He's the one that created us. He's the one that was creating this wonderful, and He knows the recipe for a wonderful life here on earth. Amen.
Well, yes, He does.
Wes, I know, I appreciate your time. I didn't mean to keep you as long, and I know that people have enjoyed this.
I've loved this.
And folks, what you need to know is right before we came on screen, I said, hey, well, it's been a while since we've sung together. Why don't we try singing together? And I think this song is completely appropriate for the way the conversation was steered by the Holy Ghost tonight. And I look forward to singing with you. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Ernie. It was such a privilege and honor to be a part of this. Please tell your guys, hey for me, and know that I love you, I miss you, and I truly look forward to the day that we can sing together again.
Yeah. Well, let's do that now, okay?
All right.
Here's a wonderful song by a dear friend of ours that we absolutely love, Steve Green. It's entitled The Word. Enjoy.